हेलो व्यूअर्स, आई एम रेणुका एंड टुडेज रेमेडियल क्लास इज ऑन इल्यूमिनेशन. इल्यूमिनेशन इज इन द थर्ड यूनिट ऑफ आर कोर्स ऑफ आरटीयू. फर्स्ट वी विल स्टडी अबाउट व्हाट आर द फंडामेंटल्स रिलेटेड टू इल्यूमिनेशन, व्हाट इज इल्यूमिनेशन एंड टाइप्स. वी ऑल नो लाइट इज द प्राइम फैक्टर इन ह्यूमन लाइफ एज वेल एज एक्टिविटीज ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स which ultimately depends upon light. When there is no natural light, use of artificial light is made, like we make use of bulbs, lightings, etc. Artificial lighting produced electrically on account of its cleanliness, ease of control, reliability, steady output, as well as its low, as it is playing an unnecessary important part in modern day every life. The science of illumination engineering is therefore of great importance. Light is a form of radiant energy. Various forms of incandescent bodies are the source of light, and the light emitted by such bodies depend upon the temperature of these bodies. Heat energy is radiated into the medium by a body which is hotter than the medium surrounding it. Heat of the body as seen can be classified as red hot or white hot. While the body is red hot, the wavelength of radiated energy will be sufficiently large and the energy available is in the form of heat. When the temperature increases, the body changes from red hot to white hot state and the wavelength of energy radiated becomes smaller. It becomes smaller and smaller and enter into the range of wavelength that of length of light. The sensation of color of light is due to the difference in the wavelength of light radiations. Visible light can have wavelength of the light between 4000 to 7500 amperes, and the color varies is as shown in the figure below. What is the sensitivity? The relative sensitivity of the eye to the lights of different wavelength varies from a person to person and also according to its age. The average relative sensitivity is shown in the figure below. The high have great sensitivity of for wavelength of about 5500. That is, yellow green can be seen under such poor conditions of illumination, whereas blue or dark cannot be seen under dim illumination. The sensitivity curve shifts as shown by the shaded region in the figure below. Therefore, violet disappears first and red still remains visible. Yellow disappears last as the illumination becomes very dim. As each color disappears, it becomes gray shade and finally black. The sensitivity of eye to yellow-green radiation is taken as unity or 100%, and the sensitivity of other waveforms is expressed as a fraction or percentage of it. The relative sensitivity at a wavelength lambda is written as k lambda and is known as relative luminosity factor. Now, illumination differs from light very much, though generally these terms are used more or less synonymously. Strictly speaking, light is the cause and illumination is the result of that light on the surface on which it falls. Thus, the illumination makes surface look more or less bright with certain colors, and it is the brightness in the color which eye sees and interprets as something useful or pleasant or otherwise. The light may produce by passing electric current through filaments as in incandescent lamp, through arcs between the carbon or metal rods, and through suitable gases as in neon and other gas tubes. In some forms of the lamp, the light is due to fluorescence excited by radiation arising from the passage electric current through mercury vapor. Some bodies reflect light in some measure while illuminated from another source. Illumination from original source, they become secondary source of light. The good example is the moon, which illuminates the earth by means of reflected light originating from sun. Now, there are various terms which are used in illumination. First, let us study them. Thereafter, we will look into the types of illumination in bodies. which lamps which causes illumination. The modern lighting schemes and selection of fittings and the type of lamps require knowledge in terms and quantity in general use for such purpose. Therefore, following definitions are given in simple form to facilitate easy identification and reference. Light. It is defined as the radiation energy from hot body which produces visual sensations upon human eye. It is usually denoted by Q and is expressed in lumen hours and is analogous to watt hours. Luminous flux. It is defined as total quantity of light energy emitted per second from luminous body. It is represented by a symbol F and is measured in lumens. The concept of luminous flux helps us to specify the output and efficiency of the given light source. Luminous intensity. Luminous intensity in any given direction is the luminous flux emitted by a source per unit solid angle, and it is measured in the direction in which the intensity is required. It is denoted by symbol I and is measured in candela or lumens per steradian. If F is the luminous flux radiated out by a source with the solid angle of omega steradian in any particular direction, then I, that is luminous intensity, is equals to F, that is luminous flux, by omega, that is solid angle, and hence it is given in lumens per steradian or candela. Lumen. The lumen is the unit of luminous flux and is defined as the amount of luminous flux given out in space represented by one unit of solid angle by a source having an intensity of one candle power in all directions. Therefore, lumens is equals to candle power into solid angle, that is Cp into omega. Total lumens given out by source of one candela are 4 pi lumens. Now, candle power. Candle power is the light radiation, light radiating capacity of a source in a given direction and is defined as the number of lumens given out by the source in unit solid angle in given direction. It is denoted by Cp. Therefore, Cp is equals to lumens per omega. Illumination. When the light falls on any surface, the phenomena is called as illumination. It is defined as the number of lumens falling on the surface per unit area. It is denoted by E and is measured in lumens per square meter or meter, candle or lux. The flux of F lumens falls on a surface area of A, then the illumination of that surface E is F by A lumens per meter square or lux. Lux or meter candle. It is the unit of illumination and is defined as luminous flux falling per square meter on the surface which is everywhere perpendicular to the rays of light from the source of one candle power and 1 meter away from it. Foot candle. It is also the unit of illumination and is defined as luminous flux falling per square foot on surface which is everywhere perpendicular to the rays of light from a source of 1 candle power and 1 foot away from it. Therefore, 1 foot candle is equals to 1 lumen per feet square is equals to 10.76 meter candle or lux. Candle. It is the unit of luminous intensity and is defined as 1/60th of luminous intensity per centimeter square of black body radiator at the temperature of solidification of platinum, that is 2043 degree Kelvin. Mean horizon candle power, MHCP. It is defined as mean of candle power in all directions in the horizontal plane containing the source of light. Mean spherical candle power, MHCP. It is defined as the mean of candle power in all directions and in all planes from the source of light. Mean hemispherical candle power, MHSCP. It is defined as the mean of candle power in all directions above and below the horizontal plane passing through the source of light. Reduction factor. Reduction factor of source of light is the ratio of mean spherical candle power to its mean horizontal candle power. That is, reduction factor is equals to MSCP upon MHCP. Lamp efficiency. It is defined as the ratio of luminous flux to the power input and is expressed in lumens per watt. Now, specific consumption. It is defined as the ratio of power input to the average candle power and is expressed in watt per candela. Brightness or luminance. When the eye receives a great amount of light from an object, we say it's bright, and the brightness is an important quantity in illumination. It is all the same whether the light is produced by object or reflected from it. Therefore, brightness is defined as luminous intensity per unit projected area of either surface source of light or reflecting surface and is denoted by L. Now, if the surface area A has effective luminous intensity of I, candela, in a direction theta to the normal, then the brightness or luminance of that surface L is equal to 1 by A cos theta, candela per meter square or nits. Nit is defined as candela per square meter. The bigger unit of brightness is luminance is stilp, which is defined as candela per square meter. Lambert is also the unit of brightness, which is lumens per centimeter square. Foot Lambert is lumens per foot square. Glare, the size of opening of pupil of human eye is controlled by its iris. If the eye is exposed to very bright source of light, the iris automatically contracts in order to reduce the amount of light emitted and prevent damage to the retina. This reduces the sensitivity so that other objects within the field of vision can only be imperfectly seen. In other words, glare may be defined as brightness within the field of vision of such a character as it causes annoyance or discomfort, interference with the vision. Specific height ratio. It is defined as the ratio of distance between adjacent lamp and height of its mountain. Therefore, specific height ratio is equals to horizontal distance between two adjacent lamp upon mounting height of lamps from the working plane. Utilization factor or coefficient of utilization. It is defined as the ratio of total lumens reaching the working plane to the total lumen given out by the lamp. Therefore, utilization factor or coefficient of utilization is total lumens reaching out at the working plane upon total lumens given out by the lamp. Maintenance factor. Due to accumulation of dust, dirt and smoke on the lamp, they emit less light than they emit when they are new ones. And similarly, the walls and the ceilings, etc., after being covered with dust and dirt and smoke, do not reflect the same amount of light which is reflected when they are new. The ratio of illumination under normal working condition to the illumination when the things are new, that is perfectly clean, is known as maintenance factor. Therefore, maintenance factor is equal to illumination under normal conditions upon illumination when everything is clean. Depreciation factor. It is merely reverse of maintenance factor and is defined as ratio of initial meter candles to the ultimate maintained meter candles on the working plane. Its value is more than unity. Waste light factor. Whenever a surface is illuminated by number of source of light, there are always certain amount of light wastage on the account of overlapping or falling of light outside the edges of surface. This effect is taken into account by multiplying the theoretical value of lumens required by 1.2 for rectangular area and 1.5 for irregular areas and objects such as statues, monuments, etc. Absorption factor. In the place where atmosphere is full of smoke fumes such as foundries, there is possibility of absorption of light. The ratio of total lumens available after absorption to the total lumens emitted by the source of light is called as absorption factor. Its value varies from unity for clean atmosphere to 0.5 for foundries. Now, I hope till now all the parameters related to illumination are clear to you. We will look after some other factors, some other parameters and definitions of things related to illumination in the next class. Till then, keep studying and do visit other remedial classes also. Thank you.